On today's episode, the world's fastest electric airplane and GM invests in electric boat technology. Today's episode is brought to you by engineering.com, a globally trusted source for engineering content. Check out this and many other exclusive videos for the engineering professional found only on engineering.com TV today. While the race for all-electric transportation naturally focuses on cars and trucks, the same technology is making waves in the aviation industry. Rolls-Royce's Spirit of Innovation test aircraft has set a new world speed record for electrically powered airplanes. 556 kilometers an hour, that's 345 miles an hour, over 3 kilometers, breaking the current record by 132 miles per hour. Tested at the UK Ministry of Defence Boscombe Down Aircraft Test Centre, the sleek single-seater also achieved 330 miles an hour over 15 kilometres. That's 182 miles an hour faster than the previous record. And it also set a new mark in time to climb, with 3,000 metres coming in 202 seconds, a full minute faster than the current record. Peak speed achieved was 623 kilometres an hour, that's 387 miles an hour. According to Rolls-Royce, this performance makes the Spirit of Innovation the world's fastest purely electric vehicle. Called ACCEL, for Accelerating the Electrification of Flight, the power plant and battery technology was provided by Electroflight and British axial flux motor pioneer YASA. The propeller is actually driven by three axial flux motors that deliver 500 horsepower combined with 90% energy efficiency. Now, typical internal combustion engines operate with a standard thermodynamic efficiency limit of about 37%, but in practice they operate around 20%. The pinnacle of internal combustion engine technology, Formula One racing cars, can approach 50% efficiency. The battery pack is the densest ever installed in an aircraft, containing 6,000 cells with a custom cooling system to reject the considerable heat generated during record runs. Flown for endurance rather than speed, the aircraft could fly 200 miles on a single charge. The 6,000 cells are divided into three battery packs for redundancy, and the entire system weighs 300 kilograms, approximately 40% of the overall aircraft weight. Battery developer Electroflight is using the technology developed for the record breaker on regional airliner development projects. The next step? Official FIA certification of the record runs. How much has this technology advanced? Well, the original prototype Supermarine Spitfire achieved a top speed of 335 miles an hour and used a 990 horsepower Rolls-Royce Merlin internal combustion engine to achieve it. If you like this show, be sure to subscribe to our channel and click on the notification bell for our next episode. With ongoing electrification of transportation on the ground, and now emerging in the air, what about the water? Well, battery electric tech is appearing there too, and General Motors has announced that it has acquired a 25% ownership stake in Seattle-based Pure Watercraft to develop the company's electric boating solutions. The plan is to integrate GM EV technology, supply chain expertise, and assembly line knowledge to allow Pure Watercraft to move their systems into mass production. Pure Watercraft currently markets converted production power boats from established hull manufacturers, as well as outboard systems to repower existing boats. Their current outboard is 50 horsepower equivalent and mounts on a standard transom. Connection is similar, with two power cables replacing the fuel line. Battery packs are modular and sit in the hull, allowing the weight to be positioned at the owner's discretion, simplifying or eliminating trim or center of gravity issues. Battery packs can be added to increase range, and systems are water resistant to the IP67 standard of the International Electrotechnical Commission, the IEC. This standard is equivalent to a NEMA Type 6 enclosure for electrical equipment, meaning the batteries are tested to stand up to immersion in water half a meter deep for 30 minutes, which should be more than adequate for recreational boating applications. Battery packs can be charged on a 240 volt system from half full to full in 90 minutes, or 5 hours per battery pack on a standard 120 volt circuit. The motor unit weighs 112 pounds, while each battery pack weighs 118 pounds. Now, according to the company, a two battery pack system installed on a bass boat will deliver 3 hours and 45 minutes of propulsion over approximately 20 miles during a typical Saturday of fishing, with a 15% charge reserve remaining. Current pricing for a single battery system is $16,500. Now, can GM's mass production expertise bring that price down? In all likelihood, yes, and it will be interesting to see how traditional internal combustion engine makers in the recreational watercraft industry respond. Well, that's it for today's episode of This Week in Engineering, brought to you by engineering.com. For our deeper engineering series, visit engineering.com TV for exclusive shows like Manufacturing the Future and Designing the Future, not found on our YouTube channel. The links are in the description below. Thanks for watching.